In this discussion, you can see how to add one-to-many field in XML file to create a new record, and we'll see the real test cases. In case you missed previous discussion about how to add many-to-one field, please check link is given in description. And this is the last discussion, like how you can add many-to-one field in XML file to create a record. And right now, if you see in this playlist, right now we are working in this playlist, Odoo Data Files Part 6. And if you are reviewing this playlist, this is the main playlist and it will cover all the Odoo's topics here. So don't worry about that. And let's back to the main topic, like how you can create record using one-to-many field. Here I will give you two scenarios. Based on the requirement, you can use anyone. If you remember the last session, CSV file to create records using one-to-many, like same way we are trying to create here also. And we will see the difference between the CSV file and XML file to define the records. So first, let me go to in editor. Let me open our custom module, this training session, like custom add-ons. And let me open this school_students model under data directory. And we are continue our record creation under this student_data.xml file. So here first we will create a new school profile in the student_data.xml file. We are not create a new data file. As you know, in our last session for the CSV files, we in compulsory we have to use the new CSV file, and CSV file name should be the same as the model name, right? Like if you are working with the XML side, you don't need to worry about to create a multiple XML files like compared to the CSV files. Even we don't need to worry about the XML file name conversion, because if you see here in the CSV file, this is the mandatory, like the model name should be the file name. But here you can add anything. And for example, if I want to create school profile or student profile, like in CSV file, it will not allow like both model record creation in the same file. But in XML file, it is allowing to create a multiple models records in single XML file. So this is the main difference here. And let me create first student profile, like record ID equal to school_, let's say 10. Then after model we have to define like school.profile, and let me close the main tag. And this is the our sub attributes, like ID and the model, and model should be the model name of the student, school profile, and ID should be unique in the database, otherwise it will override the record. And here let me add like field name equal to name, and here I will add like Nalanda University. Then after name, and in name attribute I have to define the auto rank, like let's say 10. Email, like let's say nalanda.university@test.com. Well, this is the dummy email address. And let me create here one more record for the student profile, like student_6, and the model here like school.student. And here let me add like name equal to name, and what is the name, like Chanakya as a student name. Then after field name, then after here we have to add as a school_ID, So here we have to use REF as a reference, and here I will add like school underscore 10. And let me close the field tag, and let me add here one more field as a total fees, like 5,000. So this is the first way you can create a one-to-many field like this way. Let me comment this one. For example, this is the main record as a school profile, and in the school profile having one field, the name is student underscore, sorry, school underscore list. Let me open the first module, sorry, model, and you can see like school.profile having a school underscore list as a one to many field. And this one to many field having the school dot student profile, don't worry about this name conversation, by mistakenly added as a school underscore list, but it is actually the field name should be student underscore list, but by mistakenly I added as a school underscore list, so I'm not rectifying at this moment, I'm just using this field. But here in this one to many field, we didn't define here, but we created a separate student, and here we added this school underscore ID as a many to one field as a school underscore 10 for this ID of this Nalanda University. So Odoo automatically scan this file while upgrading or installing time. That time it will create this Nalanda University record under school.profile. And then after it will comes to here, then after what happened, like the student profile automatically created as a Chanakya student name, and this student is like in this student we already defined like school underscore ID as a school underscore 10. School underscore 10 is this one, and you can and when we open this Nalanda University record over there, you can see in school underscore list having this Chanakya student. So I hope you understand this, how you can add like one to many field like this way. This is the first way, and this is very easy way, and I will show you and why this is important here. And before, let me go to in browser and let me show you the school profile. Like here you can see total 11 records is there. I mean the 11th school profile is there. If I will open anyone, you can see the students, like you can see the field name is school underscore list, then after the type is one to many. And if I will open the same like Nalanda University, here you can see like a Chanakya as a student name visible. Let me stop this service, and then after let me upgrade the module from the backend side like student. All right, it's successfully created, and let me go to list view, and you can see here the Nalanda University and total record 12. So it means one record is created from the XML file. And you can see under the this Nalanda University, you can see this Chanakya as a student, and total fees is right now 4,000. This is the student fees, but we created another fee structure, so it is also visible over there. Let me go to in student profile, and here you can see this Chanakya, then after the school name is this one, and the total fees is 5,000, what we created inside the XML file. So main interesting thing is, if I will go to here in student profile, let me open the form view, And if you see here in the view metadata, you can see the school ID, sorry, the XML ID. You can see the module name, like in which module having this record. So it is easily identified under the school underscore student, and the ID is school underscore 10. And this is the database ID, by the way. And the same, like if you see here in the student profile, and let me open this Chanakya as a student profile, and I'm going to here in view metadata, you can see here like student underscore 6 is there, and the database ID is 269. So in case you want to change anything under the student profile, then you can use the you can use this ID as a reference. Like for example, this student underscore 6, and whatever you want to change the content, you can update and it will reflect only here. But like as I said earlier, if you will comment this record, then Odoo automatically treat like student underscore 6 is not found in this specific module, then it will automatically delete the record. Let me go to front end side at this moment and let me see the ID of this Chanakya as a 269 right in the database. Let me upgrade the module. And I just commented this one. Okay, now I will go to here in the student list view, and you can see here you can't find the Chanakya as a student name because it's deleted from the Odoo side. But like for example, like I uncommented, and now I will upgrade the module. And refresh the page. Okay, you can see again it's created, and you can see ID is now the difference 270. So this is newly created record as a Chanakya under the Nalanda University. Alright, so you know the first step, like how you can create like one to many record like this way. So for example, like let me go to in school profile and let me open this Nalanda University. Now you have to add multiple multiple students here, so you can easily add like this way, like copy this one, then after paste here. And please remember one more thing is like ID should be always unique, plus then after based on your constraint, the model's constraint, you have to follow and you have to copy paste everything here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on. The student profile you can create here and just upgrade the module, and if you comes to here, it will automatically add under the one to many field. So this is the first step. And let me compare this one and the CSV file. Like in CSV file, we created two CSV files, right? Like first one is a student profile and another is a school profile. So here the main thing is in XML side, you can create under one XML file to create a multiple models record as you want. But in CSV file, it's restricted. Only a specific models records you have to create, right? Also here, the signature is also different in terms to create records. But if you see here in XML file, you have to follow the parent-child attribute, parent-child tags plus the attributes here. So this is the main difference. Now let's come to the second point. And this is very useful in terms of the backend side, like I mean the Python side, like if you want to create a dynamic records, it is also possible, but using this way, the part two way. Before that one, let me show you one chart, and you have to remember the chart when to use. Alright, so this is the chart here, like for example, if you want to create like a new record from the for the one to many field, you can easily create using like this way. Like in tuple, we have to pass 0, then after 0, Then after values, value means the dictionary. Like under the dictionary, you have to pass the field name and the value, same as the create method having that wells, right? And it will always create a new records for this one. And then after, if you want to update the created records, then you have to pass here the ID of that record. For example, student profile, if you see the school profile having a one too many field like school underscore list, and which is belong to the student profile, right? In student profile, for example, ID 1 as a Sunny is there. So if you want to change the name as a Sunny Leonie, then you have to pass here that record, and this parameter is mandatory, the first one, and this is the static one. Then after ID of that record set, and then after the value, what you want to change. So first thing is you have to remember this static value. The first one is 0, then after 1 is having a different meaning, then after 2 having a some different meaning, 3 having different meaning, like this way. So here we have to take care about these two things, like what should we need to pass here and here in second and third third parameter. Same way here also. So for example, to create a new freshly record, we have to use as a 0 or 0. Then after, you can also add as a false or false. False or 0, both are the same one in Python side as well as in XML side. So don't worry about this one. Might be you will get a lot of examples using false like this way. Or also you can see the examples like this way, but don't worry about this confusions, because 0 and false both are equal, and rest of the parameter it is the same as. Then after, like for example, you want to create a new record, you have to use like this one. Then after, if you want to change the existing record, you can use like this way. Then after, if you want to remove a particular record from the database, you can use like this way. Then after, if you want to unlink the many to one field, many to one and any specific record, it is also possible like using this way. But this command is not permanently delete the record. And if you see the what is the difference between these two is, like if you apply to, it's permanently delete the record from the database. And if you apply this one, then it won't be delete permanently from the database, only just unlink the record from the one to many relational field. That's the difference. Then after, if you want to add any existing record to the one to many field, then you have to use like this way, the fourth one. Like you have to apply as a 4, then after the specific record ID, and here we have to apply as a 0. 0 means we don't, like Odoo will not see this part, so that's why like Odoo define as a 0 signature, or you can say false. Then after the 5 means sometimes what happened, like for example in one to many field, you want to remove all the record from the one to many field plus permanently delete from the database side, then you have to apply like this, like 5, 0, 0. Then after, this is the 6, 0, IDs. This command specially used in many to many relational field. We will see all the test cases in other discussion, but right now the purpose is why I'm showing you this one, because right now we will use this one, this technique. And don't worry about these old techniques, I will show you in other discussion. Let me create a new record using this command. But again, having some questions in your mind, like how you will apply this command in XML file, plus how to define this one, and how we can know like we have to use like this one. So don't worry about this one, I will explain everything for this one only. Let's come back to our editor part. Okay, so right now you can see our first part is we created two record set, right? But now what I will do is I will create a new school profile. In the school profile, I will create
student list under the same record set. So I will not create like this, like I will not create as a separate school profile. Then after I will not create also the separate student profile. I will directly create here the only one school profile, and that school profile having student list, and those automatically create a new record. So record, then after ID school underscore 11, model equal to school profile, and here like field name, name equal to and here like email, test.com, and field name equal to auto rank 0. Okay, so here we created same as the first one, like this. But now we have to create also the student profile, but not like this way. So here, let me go to here again, models.py, and let me see, okay, this is the one too many field as a school underscore list. Let me close this one, let me close this one. Let me add here name, then after school underscore list, and let me close this one, the tag, and here we will use eval attribute. And here I will show you like how you can use this command. In list we have to use as a tuple 0 comma 0 comma, and here we have to apply as a dictionary. Now inside the dictionary we have to use like this, for example this name, Vivek student, then after like for example we have total fees colon 400. Then after, if you want to add more students, you can just use like this 0 comma 0 comma, then after inside the dictionary we have to use as a name field of the student, and here like Odoo, then after total fees like 200. But here you can see there is one different, like when you mention like this you have to mention mandatory as a school underscore ID, right? Like the school underscore 10 as a reference. So that's why like Odoo understand, okay, while loading this form view we have to display this respective student profiles. So here we don't need to add this ID here, either we don't need to add the school underscore ID as a field name, because while it will create this record, it will automatically add school underscore 11 respective database ID into this school profile. So right now we created a new school profile as a Vivekananda school. Under this school, it will automatically create two new student profiles. One is a Vivek student and another is a Weblen's Odoo. Okay, so now it's completed. Let me open the terminal and let me upgrade the module. Okay, it's successfully created. Let me open the browser. And let me go to the school profile And you can see the Vivekananda school is created. Under the school, you can see these two student is created automatically. Okay, so let me go to again in student profile. And if I will see, you can see the Vivek student and Weblen's Odu under the Vivekananda school. Right, so how, like this way it's created. And one more thing is, like using like this way means like using like this 0,0, this way you cannot find the exact database ID from the XML file, right? Like this way, like student underscore 6. So basically, if you go to in the front end side, and if you will see here in view metadata, you cannot find the XML ID. So it means it's created, but you cannot update or delete this record using the XML ID like this way. So either we have to manually update from the front end side like that way. But if you see the school profile having a XML attribute, so you can do anything using the XML ID to any operation for this record. So that's the difference between the first way and the second way. And one more interesting thing is, if you follow this tutorial from the beginning, might be you aware about, we already added one constraint in the student profile, right? Like let me close this one. So you can see this is the SQL constraint, and this is the unique name of the students here, you can see. So the basic idea is, like for example, now you want to upgrade the same module, so it will raise the error. Let's see what happened. Okay, so here, like if you go to upside, you can see like Odoo throws the error and it says like the unique constraint name will raise the error due to this duplicate key violation constraint. So for that one, like either we have to rename the student profile, student name here, or else there is one more option, like here, like no create equal to 1. But don't worry about this one. We will see the separate discussion about this one for the solution. But right now, let me go to again terminal and let me upgrade the module. For the purpose of this one, why I'm showing you the error is because, like, whenever Odoo see like this tuple, in tuple like 0,0, value, it will always create a new records. If I will remove the constraint, the SQL constraint, then it will, whenever, like for example, you 10 times you upgrade the module, then 10 times it will create this record. But right now it's not creating record because it's already added the SQL constraint here, and it's preventing to create a new record inside the database. That's why it's raising this error. And now you can see, like, we already created, I already updated the student name. And let me upgrade the one more time. And let me go to here and go to in school profile. And if I will see here, go to again Vivekananda profile, you can see like Vivek student is there. Then after Weblen's Odoo is there. Then after again, two new records created. So this is what I'm talking about. Like it won't be delete the previous records, but it will create new records inside the one-to-many field. So how to prevent this duplicate records, we will see in the specific topic. into no create attribute. That time we can use. So this is the main difference, like how you can create two new records. Like this is the parent record and this is the child record. This is the first part and this is the second part, like how you can create only one record set, and under the record set you can create multiple submodels records like this way. Plus you can also add here the different signatures, like for, then after comma, here you have to mention that specific ID and all. But right now I'm not going into deep for this one. So right now I'm giving you a basic idea like how you can also add sub records like this way. Now let's compare the scenario between XML file and CSV file. If you remember, in CSV file we already created like this way only, but this part is not supported in CSV file. For example, like in student school profile we already created like school 1, then after school 2 here, right? And then after, in the student profile we used the same reference. You can see this to school 1, school 2, like this way. And forgot about this one, this is the many to many field, like how you can add. In next session I will show you like how you can add many to many field in XML file here. But this is the different thing, and in XML file we have to define as a different way. So here we cannot use under the school profile the student records using like this way. So CSV file doesn't support like this way, but CSV file only supports like this way. So this is the main difference, and this is in XML side, this is the main advantage. So this is the main drawback for the CSV side. And I hope you understood like how to add the many to one field in XML side. If you have any query, please comment below, and see you in next session.